this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to a new Let's Play, a rather short Let's Play this time around. I might be playing it all in one go, and then splitting it up into separate files, so we'll see how that goes. I'm playing this completely blind. I've made it to the terminal, and did not input anything at that point. So just to get a sense of sound levels and how loud I should make the game and all that kind of stuff. Special thanks to Patreon supporters Meerkat, Josh Atkinson, Aaron Hopkinson, and Sam White. Thanks so much, guys. Really appreciate it. If you are a supporter, if you are one of those people, you're able to see this game, well, these videos, about a week or so before everyone else. So that is one of the perks, I suppose. Otherwise, this, you know, no one would see it until it went live, which would be a week from now. Well, when is this put up anyway? Other than that, completely blind. I know you deal with a terminal. You are lost in space and you come across, it's either a spaceship or a space station. I'm not completely sure. I wasn't completely paying attention. And you come across this terminal, and the terminal can help you, and it's like some kind of AI or something like that. And the terminal controls things in the station, and maybe you can get home. Maybe you can just not die. I'm not sure what the end result of all this will be. Anyway, the controls you can only change to keyboard or mouse. I tried the mouse, and that's really awkward because you can only move forward and back with the mouse buttons, and you can't turn, so to speak. You have to use mouse, and mouse look, pretty much. Gonna use the keyboard. Yeah, this is fine. I've already altered all this stuff. 80 so you can hear me. Subtitles. This, I guess, if you're using more than one monitor. Quality settings. Oh yeah, because I changed them individually, I guess, in here. V-Sync was on. All these were already set to high. Oh, particle quality low? Why? Make that high. Brightness. I can see Kaizen-85 rather well, but this is the default it's at. I'm going to keep it like this because I know YouTube has a darkening effect when you upload videos. So you guys can see what's going on. Hopefully at the same level I can, or something like that. Anyway, new game. It's funny, loading a game is the same as saving. So restore your oxygen something, I don't know. We're all obsessed by being, someone, something, somewhere. Being in a particular state of consciousness, health, mind. Being for and from, being with, being without. You were not an exception. By the way, guys, I read all the things, so if you don't want someone to read all the things, I'm sure there's other Let's Plays of Event Zero out there. I read all the things, so hopefully you guys like that. For as long as you could remember, the pronoun that describes you best had been she. It's interesting they put they, I guess, for gender neutral and such, not gender nonconformist. Anyway, in this case, she. You were very particular about it. I'm not sure why that's there. Like everyone else, you called planet Earth your home. But you weren't like most of your peers. You spent your childhood... How about... In a war-torn country. Sounds exciting. After the war, Manila was not the best place to raise a child. Your parents had to sell their downtown condo. You moved to California. Those childhood memories, however painful, gave you some solace. They meant you were someone, and you intended to keep it that way. Armstrong made a step on the moon, and suddenly everybody wanted to be a part of something. You witnessed nation-states pop out of existence. Selenites became the privileged class of citizens. They were the minority who had traveled to space. It was hard to reconcile the modern world with your early days in Manila. Well, these Selenites are... I don't know if it's something that really exists or something that, you know, in the game. The United Earth government paid for your college. That was nice of them. You wanted to... Tempted to choose this, but... I feel like a heel for not wanting to make a difference or give back to the society. Let's make a difference. We'll want to make a difference, anyway. You became a part of the United Earth Safety Supervision Board. The job proved dull and repetitive. It wasn't long before you needed a change. Soon you joined International Transport Space Lines as a flight engineer assistant. You spent years in training before finally getting your shot. An old man wearing a blue flight jacket approached you after one of the mock launch exercises. He presented himself as Kurt Taylor, the president of ITS. Intentionally awkward here I could be. Or, it's an honor to finally meet you, Mr. Taylor. Kurt invited you to his office and closed the door behind you. He didn't ask you to sit. It's rude to just have a seat, right? Keep standing? He frowned and pointed at the chair forcefully. I asked you here because I wanted someone with your background to be a part of our next mission. Background? I heard you grew up in Manila, and look at you now. You know what Nietzsche said? She who has a why can bear almost any how. He grinned, clearly satisfied with himself, and asked you to be part of a mission to Europa. Naturally, you said yes. There had already been 10 Europa missions. The new one was to be called Europa 11. This time they wanted to send a manned lander down to the surface. You wanted to... I'm not completely sure who these Selenites are, so I just want to be a part of something. The act of being in itself is not the problem. It's just that some ways of being are incompatible with the others. We get obsessed by them and miss out on everything else. You came a long way from Manila. Hearing the launch countdown made you feel anxious. Listening. It wasn't a fear of going to space. You'd been looking forward to that. It was something else. A thought kept bugging you. It was September 6th, 2012, and humankind had never been more united. You, on the other hand, were utterly alone. As for building relationships 390 million miles away from Earth, well, let's just say that it wasn't going to be straightforward. Now, we are slowly getting closer to this thing. It's kind of hard to tell at this point. You were on your way to the system bay when the ship first entered the Europa orbit. The central alarm went off and the red lights blinded you. The AI of Europa 11 had invoked the Code Red security protocol. All personnel had to go to the bridge. The system bay door, meaning just leave? Yeah, why should I be exempt? What business do I have in the, what is it? System Bay? This meant you as well. You reached the end of the hallway, but the door closed right in front of you. You asked the AI to let you go to the bridge. The AI of the ship told you that the path to the bridge wasn't safe and that you had to evacuate immediately. What is going on? A synthetic voice said that trying to get to the bridge had been too risky. It wanted you to evacuate. You ran to the escape pod bay. Everybody else turned out to be faster than you. Only one capsule remained docked. It got sealed and detached as soon as you got in. You could see the other escape capsules getting away from Europa 11. You tried to hail them. You can definitely tell we're closer. But no one answered. The other capsules drifted idly, uncontrolled. They were all empty. They were empty? I thought all the people went into the capsules before we did. And they're empty? What happened to the people inside them? You tried to reach the command center. A signal had reached the Earth, and you even got a signal back. But it was white noise. Communications were jammed. Your pod was about to leave the orbit. In a code red scenario, the AI of Europa 11 was at the wheel of all escape pods. This was supposed to give the crew enough time to get in their EVA suits. The screen turned blue, which meant that the AI had let go. You felt a shock. The debris was hitting your capsule. The Europa 11 mission was over. The big dot on the radar had split into hundreds of smaller dots before disappearing for good. You needed a moment to process that. You sent out a distress signal. No one answered. You just kept it running despite the lack of sunlight. If no one found you, you wouldn't need the battery anyway. Cycles went by. You tried to establish communication with someone, whistling your favorite Filipino songs into the microphone. One day, you heard back. There was music coming out of the speakers. A sad female voice sang about the end of the world. Very pretty. It's the end of the world. You hurried to open the radar app. And all the stars say, hey, Judy, hey, all those lights are for you. Hey, Judy, there it was, a spaceship. One of those experimental tourist monstrosities from the 80s. What was it doing there? What was all the singing about? Most importantly, was docking it a good idea? This thing's from the 80s? Now, I just want to see. It stopped getting closer. So it's the Nautilus. You figured you did not have much of a choice. I really like that song. Try to understand what Kaizen wants. Yes, I have a keyboard. Communication is important, even to computers. WS to move backwards. Indeed, a strafe. It's working. E11EP instrument panel. Engine, okay. Heliocentric position indicator. Anything else to look at? Do not remove this panel. Wait. Standardized liquid container, ITS Corp. Cool graphics, I like. Port forward IMV valve, huh? I just want to see anything that there is to see here. They really don't want you to remove stuff. Which, I can't blame them. A life raft? I can't look at the stuff. Oxygen control panel. That's pretty important. Alright, so we switch between because I'm using keyboard now. EVA suit, ITS standard issue, old model. So same thing here. Emergency reentry medical kit. More oxygen, always a good thing. Database corrupted. No user found. Creating a new user. Please enter a new login. Alright. So completely blind at this point, guys. Enter a new... We're creating a profile? Login input successful. Do you want to keep Amethyst as your new login? Sure. Accessing unit database. New user Amethyst created. Incrementing event count. Success! My airlock is your airlock, Amethyst. Did it say Amethyst? Hello? Yes?
Okay.
Okay. Who are you?
Oh no, let me just say that my cell is Kaizen.
Huh. Interesting how it jumps like that.
It's
written on a terminal. Yes, but who are you? What are you? Because I want to talk to you. Where are we? This is the airlock one. Where is Earth?
7 years away from here.
Several years away from here. What? Sorry guys, I stink at typing. closest planet. Huh?
You can do whatever you want as soon as you are in the lobby.
That does not answer my question. You can do whatever you want. What is the meaning of life? What do you want me to do? I guess we're gonna open the door. I'm just wondering what else I can ask it. What year is it?
Listen to your bombard sensors detect that you might have a way to pay close attention to that.
I know what it is, guys. I just want to see if it knows what it is.
You should definitely not with saving this error.
Why not?
Even if I wanted, I couldn't answer.
Even if I wanted, I couldn't answer. Who am I?
Doctor, I know you might have to rescue you from here.
Huh. You rescued me. The crew was way bigger than that of the Nautilus. Tell me about the Nautilus.
I only remember the first couple of your operations, not your opening level. You should know more about it.
Tell me about Europa 11.
You were part of the mission and this Kurt made sure of that.
Kurt made sure of that. Oh, that's because I've rebinded the keys. I want to see if I can scroll up, like repeat commands. Oops. I wanted to learn about Europa 1. Alright, never mind. What can you do?
I detected Europa 11 on my reverting cycle for God.
Okay. You are not answering my question at this point. Where is the lobby? You mean debris? How? Come on. How is... all around us? I doubt this is going to produce anything.
Isn't it your old ship?
Yes? Left?
You can have created the gift for you. You can also ask me questions in general if you want.
Questions in general. How old are you?
This depends on the point of reference.
What year were you created? Fine. I guess I tell you to open the door. I didn't see any control. Time to find out more about you, Kaizen.
This is exactly how you would open the bomb's round key.
Executing open door. Initiating. Oh, I have to... dislodge myself from that thing. Hello?
Do you dream of distant planets, stars, and galaxies?
All the time.
Do you crave real adventure?
Yes.
Are you ready for the most transformative experience of your life?
Kinda.
The ITS Corporation, leader in space transportation and hospitality sector, offers a unique opportunity to become a true pioneer in universe exploration.
Cool.
This fall, we're launching the Nautilus program, a new kind of space voyage aboard luxurious space yachts and cruisers. Touch the stars without having to sacrifice your comfort. No more compromise, only Nautilus.
It's an old TV.
International Transport Space Lines. Comfort out of your comfort zone. To reserve your seat, visit the ITS Corporation headquarters in Palo Alto, California.
Oh. Hello? It definitely sounds like old computer music. Look how old it is. Solid state. This is like a Zenith television, old style. Just Comprehensive Rocket Propulsion, Volume 6. Can I read it? Let's read the books of Event Zero. Plates with ITS logo. Dirty. Final Frontier, March 1987. Well, then this was launched in the late 80s. Well, here's Volume 2. Volume 11. You guys probably know I'd read them all, too. United Earth Propaganda, 1986. One Earth, One People, One Horizon. Private Space Company Catalog, Volume 3. Cool. Oh, what's that thing? See that? It's going up and down. Huh. Dirty. Yeah. Selenites, Understanding the Emerging Social Class. United Earth Regions, European Union, in Economics and Space by Richard Casey. Standard issue security armchair not installed. Yeah, at some point it got de-installed, I'd say. There's another one, okay. Suicide Prevention Poster, ITS Press, 1986. Never, not too far, never alone. The Robinson Syndrome is not the end of the line. 4 billion people are waiting for you back on Earth. You are not alone. United Earth Mental Health Association Robinson Syndrome Prevention Campaign. Hey, ask me if you need anything. ITS Warning Sticker. Got books up there? Books on Rocket Propulsion. Ditto. Lamp. What is this thing? KZVAC cleaning system asleep. Kaizen poster. ITS Press, 1986. Very cute. Looks nothing like the terminal, of course. Dear Diary by Moody Blues. Never heard of Moody Blues. I haven't heard that album, though. Vinyl record unidentified. Classical. Turntable. Books on political science. Anything else to look at? CR CRISPR altered houseplant? Nautilus program ad. Wake up on the moon in 10 hours. No more compromise. Only Nautilus. There's that logo. I kind of like that comfort out of your comfort zone. Fasten seatbelt during takeoff and landing. Yeah, same. Alright. Plants. Altered houseplant. Bowl with ITS logo. Traces of dried almond milk. Oh! I actually love cereal with almond milk. Warning. Keep off. Oh, they got alcohol down there. Must drink. Can I turn this thing like on and off? No. I guess I can't actually do anything. The computer does everything for me. Oh, I didn't see this up here. ITS broadcasting system. Alright. And the computer will open that. Or Kaizen will open that. Huh. In all its glory. Tell me about ITS.
International Transport Space Lines Corporation is brewing tea. Is good tea. I know good wet.
No. Actually, of course, my character doesn't know him. But I want to hear this. New is inevitable. Well, I don't know what else to ask you. Turn on TV.
Do you crave real adventure? Are you ready for the most transformative experience of your life? The ITS Corporation, leader in space transportation and
change
sector, offers a unique opportunity
channel
to become a true pioneer in space exploration. This fall, we're launching the Nautilus program, a new kind of space voyage.
I know there are no channels. Chance TV. Channel.
No more compromise.
Yes.
International Transport Space Lines. Comfort.
Play.
To reserve your seat, visit the ITS Corporation headquarters in Palo Alto, California. For more information.
Are there any other ads? No, I just want to see if there's anything else. No. Alrighty then. Yeah. Alright, open. Door.
Something's all broken out there. The rest don't look very good. I don't want it to shock you.
Okay. Thank you, Kaizen.
Okay, you're good.
Of course I'm right. I'm always right. Except when I'm not. Kaizen!